weighed 98 pounds. I was homeless. I was missing teeth. I was a horrible nightmare. And I was just ready to be done with life. I was totally ready to be done with life. And I answered an ad in the Beaches Leader. I scrapped up some money. I answered an ad in the Beaches Leader to like rent some room for like 50 bucks, you know, and I'm like, oh, I can scrap that up. Maybe I'll have a roof over my head. And so I get a roof over my head. And that night, the person I moved in with was like, I can't have you living here. You're like a crackhead. So I knew this was the end of my road. I called someone I knew that was in recovery. They took me to a meeting, and I've been clean ever since then. And I ended up getting married about a year later to the man who took me in. He was in recovery also. I married him, bought a house, got back in school, got some spontaneous, got active in recovery, started getting, you know, started working out again because I went from 98 pounds to 150 pounds. If you don't feed your body for 10 years, what you do feed it, stick with you. Man, I was chubby as hell. I was unhealthy. I was poor, so everything I ate was white. It was like grits and mashed potatoes and mac and cheese. And at my church, they would, Panera donated bread. I would take home like a garbage bag full of bread because, you know, I was so hungry. And I thought, man, I really need to try and get healthy again. So I bought a treadmill and I started just walking on the treadmill a little bit. And, you know, I lost like maybe 5 or 6 pounds. And but I kept going, I kept trying. I would go to Walmart, I'd buy a couple of DVDs and or the library and I would try those too, and it just wasn't happening like it used to in your 20s when it's just, you know, magic happens overnight. And it wasn't happening like that anymore. You know, and I'm like, oh, it's just 98 pounds. Why am I fat? I don't get this. I'm eating really poor. I feel better because I'm clean, but things just weren't working out right. And then I bought a house, I got a car, life happened, I stayed clean, I kept doing the things they told me to do. And they said this thing to me that says, if you want what we have to offer and are willing to make the effort to get it, these are the steps we took. If you want what we have to offer and are willing to make the effort to get it, these are the steps we took. And I'll repeat that again in just a minute because I heard someone say that on a team call a month ago and it changed everything for me. All right, some of the hurdles I've been through. Last weekend was exactly 2 years to the date, so it's perfect I'm here today to share this. I was in a meeting of Narcotics Anonymous. I got a text message from my husband, and it said, I hope you find happiness, and I'll tell Elvis who said hello. I'm a big Elvis fan, I think it's back here on one of my shoulders. I came home, I couldn't get in the garage, I couldn't get in the house. I don't know what's going on. I stand up on the hood of my car, and my husband is hanging in the garage. So I have two choices in life at this point. I can lay down, give up, get high, go back to what I knew that would ease the pain, or I can step up and grow and share this with other people so that no one had to go through this pain alone again. And I did that, and I made it through that. That's a milestone in my life. So February 2nd when I got clean is a milestone. Making it through April 18th is always a milestone. And the day I signed up as a Beachbody coach is another big milestone. I was looking for something. I needed something more. I was like Jessica, I was like, I'm a bartender, you know, and I like what I do and I do well at it, but I wanted something more. I have the ability to impact some lives in recovery by sponsoring a couple of girls that, you know, stay clean, but I wanted it bigger. I wanted to grow and spread this. I wanted others to grow with me. So the night before Thanksgiving, I received an invitation to become a coach from Jessica, and I thought, well, you know, it's a big day at work. I make a bunch of money today, then I'll do this. That's what I told her. She messaged me back later. Did you meet your goal today? God, she was on it. I'm like, I did meet my goal today. Okay, I will do this. I'll sign up as a coach. And I signed up as a coach, and I got T25 in Shakeology. And I thought all night long, I was like, oh my God, what have I done? I can't afford this. I can't do this. What am I going to do? I'll just try it out, and I'll send the bag back. Or I'll do the program if it works a little bit, you know, or if it doesn't work really well. I can't get rid of this belly fat with all the starch sitting there. I'll just send it back. But I did what they told me to do. If you want what we have to offer and you're willing to make the effort to get it, these are the steps we took. It applies not just to recovery, it applies to everything. Beachbody tells me this all the time. Every time I go into it, starts with Diamond. Every time I go into a coach training thing, every time I go into Dare to Dream and I look and see what people are doing, Beachbody maps it out perfectly for us. I want what Beachbody has to offer. I'm willing to do the work to get it, and they tell you the exact steps you need to do to get what they have. And I hope you want what they have to offer, and I hope you're willing to take the steps to get it, because they give you everything you possibly need. So I posted my transformation pictures, I think last week. Someone finally said, don't post other people, post yourself, be personal, be vulnerable, put it out there. I did. Yesterday, I could not get off my tablet because I woke up to 11 personal messages saying, I want this. It's like a mess, like magic. It was. I'm like, okay, I finally got out of my comfort zone, and I stopped just like piddling around with it thinking I'll just be a discount coach, and I did what you told me to do. And last month, for the first time, I became Emerald. I made Success Club. I'm on track to make it again this week. I'm going to push really hard. I'm going to do what you told me to do. So I heard Tony Stay say on a team call, if you don't listen to the team calls on Monday nights, they're like the best speaker meetings of recovery ever. They really are. It's amazing. I'm listening to the call, and I'm like, oh, I'm in a meeting of recovery. This is awesome. And sometimes it's a coach that's in recovery, and there's so many parallels between it. There are so many. But I'm able to touch much more lives with Beachbody than I ever would be in recovery, and it laid the foundations for it. I am so excited to be a Beachbody coach. I'm going to tell you one more time. If you want what Beachbody has to offer, and you're willing to take the steps to do it, anything is possible. Anything is possible. I know I'm going to reach Diamond. I know I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it by the end of the 10 weeks. You are too. Thanks for coming.